off his blazing duet.
Oh man, they're gonna go for that bottom side. Poppy needs to look for this miracle play here. 2v1, he's buying so much time, and look at the back line! For the airstrike, popped in Nino!
Kabuki, Kabuki!
Caught low, Kabuki with the flanks here! His pie jumps with the falling side, where Blazing Red popped in with a win of nature! Kabuki taking low, has a win of nature of himself! Kabuki finds the kill! Onto Nino! Pai gonna be caught in the baptism! Gonna be taken down, gunned down by Kabuki! A double kill for Aura! A massive upset in the making! Aura are looking for the Lord!
Two members taken down here, and this was crazy. Alterego Esports, they knew they couldn't win the fight in the bottom side, so you could see that Udil as well as Selly Boy hitched their eyes onto the Lord. But all they did was buy enough time for aurafire to come back and steal it out from under their nose. 6,000 goal lead here in the 13th minute. But remember, aurafire, they need to be careful with those side lanes. They need to clear. They need to keep the discipline because Alterego, it only takes one more moment, as now we're going to take a look at the items here in the 14th minute.
With the golden staff and they didn't have the sword, the wind of nature will be able to allow Nino to make out plays, but when everyone just comes around you and just encloses your escape route, it's way easier said than done. Right now with the Divine Blade in the hands of Facehugger, that is also yet another source of damage that Alterego need to be concerned with. And in comparison, Odil only has an Ice Queen's wand, so the difference in damage magically is just way too different.
On the brink of elimination, once again, Alterego gonna have to defend this one. Aurafire looking for the close. Selly Boy with the Death Dust welcome. Did not connect onto anyone. Aura looking for that bottom side now. We're gonna siege it down, just like they did in the mid lane. Holy Baptist, and Selly Boy gets sniped down! Aura are looking for it now. 1-0 down. Alterego, Pai needs to make a miracle play. Goes in, he needs to distract the members. It's actually Leo Murphy, targeted down by Fluffy, losing a whole lot of HP. Pai jumps in with the falling Star Moon. Leo Murphy falls to the hands of Kabuki, who's godlike now. 7-0-3. 15 seconds on Selly Boy. They're looking for that bottom side. Kabuki looking for the siege. Udo trying to zone him away. Minions still available. Aurafire crack the base open with another base turret secured.
Two inhibitor turrets have been taken down, but aurafire, they remained disciplined. They wait for the waves to crash. They realize that Selly Boy and Leo Murphy are going to be up very soon, and they don't want to make the huge risk. They don't want to make a blunder here in the 15th minute because the counters are going to be highly, highly against them. They are able to achieve by taking away the jungle away from Alterego Esports. Selly Boy left with nothing here in the 15th minute.
Notice how defensively Nino is playing, man. His Battle Mirror image has been placed behind him just in case aurafire makes that decisive play towards him. So as a result, he just isn't able to get behind and do that damage. Not yet so far. Aurafire now trying to get control, cutting off the escape route of Alterego. But Selly Boy now, he goes for an Athena, despite the fact that Kabuki was able to just absolutely nuke him down. Lord won't be up for another 30 seconds, and aurafire, they're just controlling the jungle, making sure that their gold lead stays as far as possible.
If Alterego Esports can take down Kabuki, then that's GG. That's all they need to achieve at this point. How can they try and do this, as they don't have any heroes that can actually dive into the back line other than the Claude with a Blazing Duet, but risking their gold laner, I don't think that's worth it. It could be detrimental to their win here.
It just depends on how the fight plays out, because when the fight gets chaotic, I really feel like Alterego's composition really thrives in that kind of environment. But if aurafire are able to maintain distance, make sure there's a solid front line, and crowd control Alterego away, they have the advantage for sure.
Once again, heavy spin and the feathered airstrike. Two massive resources. Three now with the Nibiru's Passion.
Whoa.
Pop already. Nino has to go to that top side. Aurafire playing this really well, trying to bait and trying to use this man advantage as Paquito is looking for the flanks. Now, limits of it all, Pai goes in for Falling Star Moon, cancelled out by Godiva, who's going to be losing his immortality. Fluffy in the back lines now, going for the knockoff strike onto Selly Boy, but the Lord knocks him up. That's Selly Boy taken down, no jungler for Alterego. Nino still has his Blazing Duet, he jumps back with the BMI. Kabuki taking so much of that damage on. High picks up the red tree on the Lord. Fluffy jumps in onto Udil, has the guy to win to bring him back. Alterego now looking for the defense. Enhanced Lord marching down in the mid lane. Oh my god, ooh. Kabuki with a flicker play. Wanted to go for it. Minion wave still now coming in. Fluffy jumps in with a knockoff Swaggers. That's gonna be Pi looking for the falling. Simon blazing Nuet onto the back line. And the heavy spin pins him down. But he has the win of nature. He's still surviving. One more hit is all it takes. Fluffy picks up the kill. His immortality will be popped in. Udil trying to look for the defense right now as Liam Ripping is taken down by Kabuki. Udil against the world. Udil looking for the defense. Kabuki hits
tower,
on
tower,
the
tower.
Base. And look at this. Another upset. Ladies and gentlemen, throw your predictions out the window. Molded from the ashes. Aurafire. Destroy Alterego.
Aurafire being able to go to the next stage. As unfortunately, it's going to be the three face masks who go home today. And this is a huge upset. You can see the reactions of the players, the audience.
Wow, we're just completely speechless here, man. This was their season. We said it. The pattern is reversed. They were on an upward trend coming into the playoffs. But unfortunately, season 10 is absolutely ruthless. There is no room for an easy prediction.
Man, tears in the venue right now. And we do understand this was their last chance to continue their journey throughout the playoffs. And it had to end here on the first day, being the first team to go home. It must have been tough. We felt we were there for them. We experienced the journey that they had this season. Earlier on, it was shaky. Second leg, they found their groove. Stronger after the patch. But unfortunately, it has to end here.
Alterego will be the first team eliminated from Season 10 playoffs. The look of disappointment. But wow, just goes to show how unpredictable Season 10 is. We're gonna hand it over to Alterego for a speech, a final speech towards the fans. The Alter champs, giving them the last send-off in Season 10.
Does seem like they're feeling it a little too much. They won't be